Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Alaskan Lujay, and welcome back to Dishonored. Let's go. What? No, I'm not on Red Bull. You're on Red Bull. What are you talking about? Shut up. Okay, now we are back in our house, and we are going where? Admiral Havelock. That's right. We just got back from... If there is one thing I do not like, it is people interrupting my commentary. Morning, boys. What you up to on this fine day?
Hello, Corvo. I expect Martin will be joining us shortly.
Mm-hmm.
I hate to start your day with such a strange matter, but the servants heard something last night, moving through the storm drains beneath the building.
Oh, that's right.
Most likely a weeper, the poor bastard.
Weepers.
There's no hope for them once the plague gets that far along. Nothing more than a shuffling corpse full of sickness and insects, if you ask me. Here's a key to the hatches. I'd send a servant down there, but they'd die of fear on the spot, I'm afraid.
Yeah, not me, though. Nerves of steel.
Sort of sleep poison for your crossbow if you want to go that route.
Pretty sure I'm full up on sleep darts. Oh, no. No, I'm not. Well, first we have looting and purchases and runes and things to take care of. So first, runes. Whoa, three! Nice! I completely forgot to spend those at the end of the last episode. All right, let's see. What do we want here? Bending time. That's very useful for escapes. If there's a whole lot of guys around and I need to run. Oh, but we don't have the level 2 blink yet. Yeah, we want that. That increases our blink distance, makes us much more maneuverable. Okay, upgrades. Wow. Look at the range on that now. Kapoofus.
I know the golden cap. Not as a patron, mind. I designed some specialized devices for them. I kept the blueprints, if anyone is curious.
Don't. I brought you tea as a courtesy to a colleague. I won't make that mistake in the future.
I'm sorry. I only thought... Never mind what I thought. Thank you for the tea.
I have to get back to the Admiral. He has news for me.
Piero, you really need some help understanding girls, don't you? Besides, Callista is my bae now. Hands off. Also, can I buy things from you? 1,191 coins. Not bad. Mask optics. That's good. That makes my snipingness better. Now, it said improved armor. Nice. We need reduced damage because I'm very stupid. That pretty much cleaned me out, actually. Is there anything I should buy? Oh, sleep darts are dirt cheap. Yeah, I probably better... I'll get a couple of those, just in case. If I get into a pinch down there. Because weepers, by the way, are zombies. If you didn't guess from Havelock's description of them as shuffling corpses filled with insects. The first time I played this game, I was already pretty much in love with it by this point. But when they added zombies to the mix, that made it oh so much better. Here, zombie, 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 zombie. Here, zombie, zombie. Where your ugly rotting ass at? I know they're technically called weepers, but zombie just sounds cooler. I don't know why they didn't go with that from the start. Oh, 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 oh. Okay, yep, there he is. Hi, zombie. Oh, there's more than one of them. All right, well, we'll start with this guy and see what happens. Oh, maybe not. Run. I'm not gonna be no zombie food today. Thankfully, they're not as intelligent as normal people, so they're kind of slow. If they do see you, they can get some running momentum, but they're even less perceptive than the guards, if that's possible. And thankfully, they can still be knocked out, even though they're undead. I'm not sure, what's even the word for what I'm trying to say here? I'm not sure what the biology of that is. I'm not sure if normal zombies, he says, as if they exist. I'm not sure if being able to be knocked out is part of zombie lore anywhere, but these can, so that's lucky. Other Mr. Weeper went over here. He also doesn't appear to be moving, and I can't get around him, so we're gonna have to use one of those sleep darts. Nighty-night. Ooh. Ooh, is that a rune I hear? It is! Yes, yes indeed. Oh, that was pretty easy.
Down there in the sewers? I thought I heard a weeper in there earlier. You're probably the bravest man I've ever met. Overseer Martin.
Well, you know, I have my moments.
He's with Admiral Havelock now. They want to talk to you.
Alrighty. Sup, fellas? How you doing?
Corvo. I trust you remember Martin. an overseer before, and perhaps again.
Yeah, I was kind of a dick to him earlier.
I owe you thanks for my rescue.
No, your eventual rescue.
You've given us a glimmer of hope, Corporal.
Sorry about that, by the way.
We've gotten what we wanted from Campbell's journal. We know where Emily Caldwin is being held.
Yes.
The golden cat, of all places.
Oh, that's right. It's
a
this level.
For aristocrats. Little better than a cursed brothel.
But there's an unfortunate twist. It appears that Pendleton's own kinsmen stand in our way. The twins, Morgan and Custis. Not only are they controlling Emily, but they have the controlling parliamentary votes.
Boring alert. Boring alert. Emergency skip initiated.
Oh, wait a minute. Before we go talk to Pendleton, though, there is a rune. Bloop. Rune. I think that means we can get that other level of vitality now, because I have two of them. Pretty sure. No? Oh, it costs three runes. Bend time doesn't, though. All right, we'll go with that.
A moment, if I may.
Oh, right.
The Royal Protector. Just the man I needed to speak with.
Yeah.
Corvo, I've asked to speak to you myself. You see, I'm sending you to kill my older brothers, Morgan and Custis.
Mm-hmm.
They're horrible men. It's true, as you may have heard. Cruel beyond words. Further, my brothers are close allies to the Lord Regent. And as long as they are in Parliament, we cannot gather the votes we'll need to...
Boring alert. Boring alert. Boring alert.
Now go. Please do it before I change my mind.
You drink kind of a lot, you know that? I'm surprised you're even standing. Okay, Samuel. Onward with us. I think I've taken care of everything here. Yeah, let's go.
I'll get you as close as I can to the Golden Cat, Corvo.
Namely, the exact same spot you dropped me off last time.
Slackjaw might have some ideas on helping you get inside the cat, if he don't kill you. This here's his territory. He and his Bottle Street gang hole up at the old Dunwall Whiskey Factory.
Yeah, I know. I made a new friend there. Harold. He's a great guy.
Good luck to you. I know Emily must mean a lot to you.
Well, I mean, she is my daughter. I mean, no, she's not. Ignore that. Pretend you didn't hear that.
There's one of those watchtowers on Clavering now.
Ooh, right. Forgot about those. Oh, yeah. Campbell's a little... Well, I mean, he's alive, but he's not... Ooh, yikes. Oh, yeah. That's what the watchtower does. It fires incendiary bolts at people. It's not very nice. Ah, our first customer of the day. And how are we today, sir? Just come right this way with me. Corvo's premium naps are back in the distillery district for a limited time only. Lots of bone charms in this area, but no runes right now. Let's go talk to Granny. Maybe she'll have something for us. Oh, wait a minute. I guess she got evicted. That's weird. I could have sworn she stayed in the same place for this level. Okay, well, guess we won't be getting any runes from Granny today. So Samuel said something about Slackjaw being able to help me infiltrate the Golden Cat, so... Whoa, hold up. Oh, there's an assassin poking around up there. These guys are trickier because they're Dowd's men. I don't know if you remember from the first episode, he's the guy who actually killed the Empress. They have my same blink power. So you gotta really be sneaky with them or they can get you into a lot of trouble. Heh. Not sneaky enough. Gotcha. Oh, bone charm. I wasn't even looking for that. I probably should be getting those. The bonuses they give are slight, but some of them actually can be really useful if you make your build correctly. Like that one, see? Move faster while carrying corpses. That's kind of important. So what can we get rid of? The glass thing has actually been way more useful than I thought. Oh, that's right, you guys weren't there for that, were you? Yeah, I got a lot of DLC that gave me a whole bunch of bone charms, so we've got... glass sound reduced, swim speed increased, damage resistance from explosions reduced, damage resistance from explosions reduced,
damage resistance from explosions reduced,
power effects increased, white rats can be consumed and white rats don't attack you. We're gonna get rid of white rat friend because the only times that rats attack you in the first place is when they're in a swarm and then there's way more normal rats than there are white rats. And that one saw me. Ow! Jesus Christ! They have crossbows. Very accurate. Not very smart, though. Didn't try to chase me. Whoa! Whoa, 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 whoa! That guy showed up right behind me! Take back what I said about them not trying to pursue me. That was lucky as all hell. Whoops. Bunch of weepers down there. I didn't kill him, though. I only knocked him over, so that's a plus. Time to go have a chat with Slackjaw. Of course, I imagine Slackjaw probably isn't too happy because some devious person poisoned his bootleg elixir, making all of his men sick. But he doesn't need to know that. Oh, wait a minute. They're not against me. I don't need to be sneaking around. Hey, boys. What's up? Wait a minute. Hey, look! It's Harold!
You're supposed to prevent the plague sickness. Fight it off. But someone poisoned the bootleg still, and now we got the elixir that gives you the plague.
That was me. Sorry.
I don't think that's what that word means, idiot.
Well, how would I know? It's some other word then. Anyway, I almost feel sorry for the poor fools that drank that bad elixir.
Well, I'm glad you are of a stronger moral upbringing than those other people, Harold. Makes me proud to know you, and proud to have thrown bottles at your head. And also, you still seem to be able to speak very well, so apparently being unconscious didn't damage your brain too much. God, I'm so tempted to start throwing bottles at him again. Look, they all respawned in the same places. I don't want to piss off my truce with the Bottle Street guys for now, though, so I will restrain myself somehow. Ah, Slackjaw, I presume?
Somebody put plague in the brew tank. Half my men are weepers.
What an asshole, right? Distillery. Who would do that?
I may have a point of interest for you, see?
Oh, you're not much of a mobster, are you? You have the wrong accent for that kind of talk.
Way I figure it, there ain't nobody worth killing around here except those two Pendletons over at the Golden Cat. I'm right, ain't I? See, Slackjaw knows.
Slackjaw also refers to himself in the third person.
Maybe I got a better way to take care of them too. If you're doing something for me first, understand?
Sounds good to me.
Someone, I don't know who, is killing my men, taking my territory, stealing my goods. Might be a fellow name of Galvani. I sent my best man to investigate, but he went missing and... Well, now I need someone to find what happened to him.
Okay.
Go to this Galvani's place. He lives nearby.
Yeah, I know. I stole You do that. I stole something from him earlier. Cat. My, oh my, there's a lot of goodies in this area. Well, most of it was weapons, but there were quite a few valuables in there also. And speaking of which, I got a blueprint called incandescent paste or something like that. What does that do? Pyrotechnic substance that ignites to produce intense light for a short duration. Hero can use this to upgrade your crossbow bolts. Huh. I don't think I've ever found that before. That's new. Does that mean if I fire normal crossbow bolts in front of somebody, it'll blow? Oh, shit. Who let those weepers out? Well, you know, if you guys want to kill him, that's your deal. Hi, Weepy Poo. I will be on my way. You guys don't seem too interested in me, do you? Whoa, no. Take that back. Get off me. Get off. Thank you. She's a tiny freaking QTE up in the top left corner there. Thanks for letting me know, game. Okay, so they were in a cage over here and they got out. How did that happen? Ooh, bone charm. Potions give you slightly more mana. I like it. That means I can use my powers more. Probably don't need the river affinity thing. If I'm swimming, I don't need speed. What are you guys doing? Oh, and they got a hold of some weepers. Oh, is he gonna run into the wall of light? I wanna see that. Nope, he's just going back downstairs. Darn. Man, they are really riled up down there, aren't they? This would be a perfect opportunity for me to run right through there, but unfortunately I have business to attend to. Oh, guards. Okay, which way is he going? Gotcha! Damn, I'm good! This extra blink range really does help. I can just teleport right behind a guy from clear across a room and knock him out without even having to do any kind of stealth approach or get close. Oh, I just read a note about this safe. I have a vague memory of where the key to it is, too. It's down in... I don't even remember. I think it's down in, like, a sewer drain or something. Okay, I have an experiment to try. Not that. There we go. Oh, well, that didn't work. Come here, fool. What? Wow! That was a spectacular miss. I'm just gonna leave you some time to sit here and think about how you could maybe benefit from a little target practice. Crowley's last message. Alright. That's probably good enough for Slackjaw. Now let's just finish looting the place and get the hell out. Hello, gentlemen. Harold, how you doing? No, wait, you're not Harold. I don't think Harold had mutton chops. Or, those aren't mutton chops. That's like... Okay, so your sideburns come down and turn into your mustache. Was that a thing? Just makes you look like you have dog lips or something. Mustache chops. Weird facial hairstyle.
Hey, wait a bit. What just occurred to me? How come it's always me who pay for the whiskeys?
Shush up your mouth. You know I can't work out the right number of coin. It's embarrassing.
That explains why they never seem to be able to see me or find me. They're dumb as bricks. Harold, you around here, man? Please don't tell me you got killed by the Weepers. Hey, dude, have you seen a guy named Harold around here anyway? Big burly guy, stupid look on his face? Oh no, wait, that's everybody in this building, never mind. Wait a minute. Harold! What's up, my man? Glad to see you're still alive. That Weeper thing that just happened outside was kind of scary. So, how've you been? The whole headache thing turn out all right? Did you get any cool scars from it? Chicks dig scars, Harold. Really, you should be thanking me. No? Not in a chatty mood right now? That's cool, man. We can catch up later. Peace out. Oh, Slackjaw's up there now. Went all the way back into that distillery lab for nothing. Hey, Slackjaw, got something for you.
What's this? Information from my missing guy.
Mm-hmm.
Let's have a listen. Now maybe we can help each other out again.
Well,
I could get rid of the Pendletons for you.
Oh.
Quiet-like and without killing them. But you gotta do something for me in return.
That's fair, I can do that.
Including an arts dealer named of Bunting. Got some pretty fancy stuff locked away at his place.
Ooh.
And the only thing preventing me from nabbing all that loot is the combination to his safe. Bring me that combination, my masked friend, and then I take care of the Pendleton brothers. Just like that. You ain't never even gonna touch them. And I promise, I won't kill them, and no one will ever see them again.
Nice.
Now if that ain't a deal, Slackjaw don't know what is.
Alright, sounds good to me. Of course, I don't really like Slackjaw because he's a dirty freaking mobster, so what we're going to do is get that combination, take that very useful information that Slackjaw gave us, open the safe, loot it, then come back to Slackjaw with the combination and let him go loot the empty safe. Besides, the name of the game is getting power anyway, and money means more upgrades, which means more power. So really, it's the only logical course to take. Sorry, Slackjaw. Whoop, not good. Not good. Hi, guys. I'm not doing good with the stealth today. Nighty-night. That pose, though. Your neck doesn't look too good there, bud.
That was great, the way he just charges at me. Heck!
Here we go. Wouldn't want you to wake up with a crick in your neck. That'll last for weeks. Just move you guys to a slightly more comfortable position. And by more comfortable position, I mean I'm going to stack you like everyone else I kill. Or not kill, knock out. I don't kill people, what am I saying? Oh no, I'm out of sleep darts. That's not good. And I think he said there were more guys. Yeah, there's two more.
Stop your crying and give another shove. Just imagine what could be behind it. That'll get you through.
I mean, or you could just try every combination. It's only a 3-digit combination. It probably wouldn't even take that long. I could probably do it. Normally, I would be tempted to just try every number to crack it open just to be able to say that I did, but since being able to get that combination is part of the mission anyway, it's probably not worth it. I'm guessing this dude is just gonna stay there warming his hands. Yep, not paying attention. He did move. Thank God he didn't look this way. Oh my god, look at them. The one thug is giving the other thug a handjob. Oh, that's priceless. That made me almost forget what I came over here to do in the first place. You remember in the other episode when I said I was gonna make a pyramid? You guys thought I was kidding, didn't you? Well, voila, there you have it. Jeez, they're so tangled up you almost can't tell whose legs are whose. This guy looks like he's... like his leg comes over and then breaks in that direction. That's weird. Provided his pants change color, but details. Nobody needs to care about the details. Now, I did, whoop, yep, there's definitely a guy still left up here. I'ma just need to knock your sorry ass out. Sorry about that. There we go, everybody pair off.
Look at the bone signal with their feet covered up like that. It even looks like a penis. I did not do that on purpose. Holy shit. This episode is going fantastically so far. I wonder if the developers ever thought of that while they were making this game. You know, there had to be that one guy in the team who was like, hey, let's draw this crossbone thing and then they can go lay the bodies over it and it'll look like penises. And they're like, shut the hell up, Steve. What is wrong with you? Get back to animating those textures. Animating textures? Really, Jay? That's not how game design works. Why does my mouth always have to move faster than my brain? Oh man, that was amazing. I'm still lightheaded from laughing so hard. Oh, there's a watchtower. Alright, well, you don't need to see me ever. We'll just depower you. Okay, are there dudes? Yeah, that dude is gonna see me. That's another problem with this mission being in daylight. I'm easier to see. Okay, well, he's going that way, so now's my chance. There we go. Ooh, bone charm. Again, I wasn't even looking for that one. So what does that do? Is it the bone charm that'll make my sneeze go away? I hope so. Oh, ammo. Find ammo in greater amounts. Yes, I do. Especially when it comes to sleep darts. Gutter feast isn't really necessary because the white rats really don't give me all that much mana. And you tend to only find them in crowds that can deal a lot of damage when they swarm you. And I haven't really ever run low on potions because I'm pretty stingy with my mana powers. I'm careful to not waste it most of the time anyway, unless I'm running away from something. Yep. Speaking of rat swarms, no, bad rats. Fuck off. Get away. Fuck off. No. You're not getting out of it that easily. You don't get blood on my sword, so that doesn't count as killing. All of you can die. All of you. Every single one. Screw you, get back here. We're doing a Tom and Jerry thing right here. Get back here, you goddamn not mouse, rat. Damn it, I said Tom and Jerry and that threw off my brain. Wait, where'd it go? It went into the bed and died or something because I can't see it. Only thing that matters to me, though, is that they're not here anymore. Alright, onward to the Golden Cat. Like Martin said, this place is basically a PG-13 hooker house. See? Because, like, they don't have boobies out or anything, but they're still very scantily clad. How are you? What? I'm not that scary. Chill out, guys. Wait, are there even guys coming? No? Okay, first of all, I'm not doing anything. I just stopped by to say hi. Second of all, I heard guys Oh, hi. I'm gonna be going now. Nice talking to you. Ow. Bitey fish. I regret this decision. Almost forgot the most important thing of being here, which is to check for runes. And sure enough, there's one right over here in this building. Rune? Where are those other runes? Because I want to get in as close to those as I can, so I don't have to move much. Oh, there's a nice open window over there. Ooh, watch this. Okay, see, that's the... I know because I played this game before. That's Madame Prudence. She's the pimp of this place, even though she's female. Can you have a female pimp? I'm not sure. Not really familiar with that terminology. What I do know is that this guy is not paying attention and is looking completely the wrong way. So the next time he moves, I'm just gonna pop down there, steal her key, and pop right back up out of the way. God, I'm good. What's in here? No immediately apparent bad guys. Ooh, there's a bone charm up there. And nobody's in here, so we're good. Ooh, monies. Monies galore. More monies. That was a lot of monies right there. I'm getting rich off of this room. Room? Yeah, that was the right word. I was getting room and rune confused right there. I don't know what I was thinking. Climb faster? Nah, I don't really need that. I think that rune is pretty much directly above me here, because I can hear it whispering. Yeah, there it is. And we have a Lady of the Night over here. Probably no need to scare her if I'm careful. We can just pop in, grab some stuff, pop right back out while she's not paying attention. Damn, girl, that's a nice booty, though. Oh, she's got some valuable stuff over there, though. Sorry, babe, I really need to steal all of your money and stuff, so we're just gonna put you out here.
Again, like I said before, if you have to knock the lady out, at least make sure she's comfortable. Those legs, though. There you go. Whoa, panties. Okay, I'm I may be an asshole, but I'm not a pervert. And no, I'm not a prude either. It's just that ogling women, especially when you have knocked them out, is not something I feel particularly comfortable with. It's called consent, people. Even with NPCs. Sorry if I sound a little salty about that. Oh, hey, Emily! Hi!
Why are you wearing that mask?
I did not expect to accidentally walk in on you there. I was not paying attention to my markers again.
Corvo, it's you!
Hey, kiddo! How you doing? Yeah, a little bit.
They told me you were head chopped off in the prison, dead, like mother.
Nope, they're just trying to scare you.
Seems like a long time ago.
They can't kill me, I'm way too much of a badass for that.
Dead.
Nope!
Now we can leave, I have a plan, I almost got away twice.
That's
There's
cool.
A special door to come and go, for special people, and I'll show you. And if anyone tries to stop us, you can fight them.
They won't be trying to stop us, I'll make sure our path is clear long before then.
It's this way.
Emily, I still actually have some stuff to do. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna get her to the door and make sure she's safe, and then go ahead and take care of the rest of what we're doing here. Emily, dear, you need to be careful. There's bad guys around here. Emily, don't get too far ahead.
Don't get seen, please.
Okay, there we go. Thank God. Okay, kiddo, you just stay here. Yeah, I know. I have the key. Just stay here, okay? Corvo has some business to take care of. I will be back for you, and I will make sure that no bad guys come sneaking this way. We just need to take care of a thing. You don't need to know what. It involves me getting very rich and probably pissing off the city's biggest gangster. Oh, that was close. Almost got seen. I keep not being at the right range. It keeps costing me. Oh, wow. Hi, girl. You didn't even notice anything. Don't even worry about it. I'm just gonna take this rune over here and be on my way. Oh, also some noms. What's through this door? Guards, of course. And two chicks making out over there. I guess nobody in there got the memo that there's a prowler on the loose, as they say.
You're supposed to be on duty. Come on. You're supposed to be on guard. You'll get dismissed for sure. I can't believe this. You said you weren't even drunk. Wake up.
Wow, somebody sucks. I think I'm clear. Those two clearly aren't paying attention. That guy's not paying attention. That lady's not paying attention because she's paying attention to him. That guard's looking the other way. Yep, think I'm good. Let's go. Nailed it!
Finally, I've been like this for 20 minutes.
Yeah, this part's weird.
Footsteps sound a little loud. Have you gained a little weight, honey?
Yes, dear.
Time for the trolling to commence.
Oh, that's good. I deserve that one.
I'm trying to press it when he doesn't want me to. Do I have to get this guy off? Is that absolutely necessary? What kind of weirdo do you have to be to get turned on by being electric shocks?
That was perfect. But it's all I can take for tonight. Call my servants. We're done.
Okay, thank God I finally get to have some fun. Zap!
We're done, I said. Retribution! Now let me out!
No. Zap! The combination to your safe.
The safe, yes, of course. The combination is 696. My heart skipped.
Holy shit, this episode is awesome with the innuendos. I'm gonna have to title this the sexual episode or something. What are the odds of that the code you would get from the guy in the brothel has 69 in it? Oh my god, that is amazing. So now I need to get back out. Go to that safe at the art dealer's place, punch in the code, and then probably go back to Slackjaw, right? He said he wanted me to bring the code back to him. I'm not seeing an optional objective there of any kind. Okay, probably better be ready to run. Nope. As usual, I got the skills to pay the bills, and nobody even saw me. No, no, guys, leave me alone. Can any of you at home even still understand me through the foot in my mouth right now? Gonna have to jump for it. Ah, nailed it. Whew, just barely. Look at that, another foot, and I would have dropped right back down into that same situation. Now we're back at the art dealer's place. Does anybody happen to remember what the code was? Oh, right, 696. That's fantastic. Ooh, look at all these potions and things. That painting is probably nice. Custis Morgan and the Postulate Child? They didn't even name Lord Pendleton? Anyway, runes are always nice. Now I can buy something. Let's see. Movement speed is increased. That would be useful, and definitely less boring than having better health regeneration. Ooh, possession could be... Wait a minute, I have 5 runes? How? When? Was I just totally not paying attention the whole rest of this time? Probably not. Agility seems good. Being able to run away from pursuing bad guys kind of seems important. Oh yeah, wow, look at that. Damn, I'm fast. Now to shut and lock the door again so Slackjaw and his thugs don't suspect anything. Mighty effective combination lock we've got right there. Works so well. And now here we are back at the distillery district to whisper sweet lies into Slackjaw's ear. Hello, Slackjaw. Guess what I found? A combination to that safe. Totally didn't steal everything inside and loot it myself, by the way.
You brought me the numbers. I've been after this combination for months. If you ever need steady work, you come see me. Slackjaw knows a good man when he sees one. It's only natural that you'd be curious about what I intend to do with the Pendletons.
Don't really care, but please,
see,
go ahead.
Pendleton's got these rock mines. Mm-hmm. Have hundreds of souls working down there half a mile deep below ground.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm gonna shave their heads and cut out their tongues and put them in one of their own stinking mines. I'm gonna see life from a different angle.
That is beautiful poetic justice. I completely forgot what it is that he did to the Pendletons. That is so good. Social justice at its finest. Good God, I'm fast. I bet this also means I can jump bigger gaps now, since I have more momentum. Can I jump this gap? Ah, just barely didn't make it. Okay, well, that's a good benchmark, then. It's gonna be really interesting to see if Slackjaw acts any differently because I stole everything out of that safe. I don't remember one way or the other. I don't think he does. That would be kind of cool, though, if the developers had anticipated that the player would do that and change the story one way or another because of it. Although, come to think of it, I'm not sure I ever even have an occasion to talk to Slackjaw again. So I guess we'll kind of see. Okay, so now all I have to do is get back over to Emily, and we're home free. Back, kiddo! And considerably faster, you will notice. Daddy's been doing some leg workouts in the past half an hour. It's amazing what a little... We're gonna try that one again. Hey, what's up, kiddo? I'm back, totally for the first time since you saw me recently. Also, considerably faster, you'll notice. Daddy's been... I mean, Corvo's been doing some workouts. I really am not good at being discreet, am I? It's amazing what a little jogging will do for you in your spare time.
Let's get out of here.
Agreed. Oh, you want me to go first? Okay, that's understandable. After all, you are, like, 10.
I'll wait for you near the boat.
Oh, I could have just gotten you out of here safely the whole time? Well, that was a lot of worry for nothing. Better not be bad guys out here. Oh, hey, there's Granny.
Come to dinner now.
I see you moved.
Sweet little bird.
Oh, and you have a bone charm. How nice of you. Rat scent? That doesn't sound like a good thing to me. If anything, I don't want to smell like rats. Oh, rats attack you only when you walk closer. Is there anything I'm willing to give up for that? I feel like damage from explosions isn't something I should have to worry about too much. At least not yet, so we'll get rid of that. Actually, you know, you have to be pretty dumb to walk into a crowd of rats in the first place, so maybe I'll just put that back. Never mind. I mean, don't get me wrong. I am very dumb, but I feel like I have a better likelihood of getting surprised by somebody with an explosive crossbow later in the game. Yes, those are a thing, than I do of walking into some rats. And if that does happen, I can just slice the little bastards. I have no problem with that. How's it going, Granny? Granny?
It's good to see you again, dear.
Mm-hmm.
But don't dally, or that young girl might fall in the river.
That's charming. I'm glad you guys got along well. You wouldn't happen to have any more runes on you, would you? Not sure if I found all the runes in this level or not. In any case, I'm too lazy to go looking for them again, and I'm pretty overpowered as it is, so I don't feel like we'll have too much of a problem. Oh, this is where those guys were having their skirmish earlier. That's nice. Bodies that I don't have to be responsible for, and all the more money for me. Whoop! No you don't. This is a thing that needs to not be a thing. Can you rotate back over here, please? Mr. Watchtower? Come on. Come on. Oh, just barely close enough. Beautiful. And now, we will observe, as this guard down here shits his pants. as well as everyone else in the vicinity. You guys just stay over there, nice and distracted. I will be on my way.
Corvo, you must have worked wonders out there in the city tonight.
A little bit.
My old eyes.
Well, I mean, I do have superpowers. That does make it kind of easier. Home sweet home.
So you did the business, did you, Corvo? I'm not one to speak against my betters, mind you, but if anybody ever deserved their fate, it was those Pendletons.
I didn't kill him, actually.
What business are you talking about?
Gave him a fate much worse.
Oh, I, grown-up business, girl. I mean, your ladyship. Forgive me.
It's okay. I heard a lot of grown-up business at the Golden Cat.
Phew, I bet.
I should concentrate on piloting this business.
Yeah, I imagine some of Emily's girlish innocence is now lost forever at this point.
You do not fail to impress. Armed with a blade, you've changed the course of the city forever.
Little close there, Havelock.
Our own Lord Pendleton will assume their votes in Parliament.
Boring alert. Boring alert.
Personal space bubble, my friend.
In one night, you've done more than most men do in a lifetime.
Again, superpowers.
I need to speak to you soon. But for now, Lord Pendleton requests your attention.
Alrighty. Okay, he's chilling out there by the cliff. Probably drunk off his ass again. Any more things for me to loot magically pop up while I was away? Doesn't look like it. Okay, well, we'll just go talk with Pendleton then. Ooh, nope, I take that back. Here's a couple of things. And let's chat with Piero and get some stuff. Ah, there, see? Now we can buy incendiary bolts here if we want. Because of that blueprint that I found. Piero's got a rune. Cool, I'll take that. Upgrades. Bone charm capacity. Enables one additional bone charm to be active, total 4. You're not quite doing the math there. I actually have 7 already, so this will be total 8. I will take that, though. Never know when you might need more bone charms. Plus, I don't really have a need for any of this other lethal stuff. Oh, the crossbow reload might be useful, though. Yeah, I think we'll take that, instead of the other bone charm thing. I bet I can wrangle up some more money and get the bone charm thing by the start of the next mission anyway. Anything else? Some food. Don't need the health, though. So, yeah, let's just go talk to Pendleton.
Corvo, the Loyalist Conspiracy thanks you for your work. I don't know if I can. My own brothers.
They're not dead.
We never believed that you killed the Empress. It made much more sense that the Royal Spymaster, now the Lord Regent, was behind it, aided by some of his key allies.
Too bad the rest of the Empire doesn't seem to understand that.
We spent a lot of money and exposed ourselves to great risk in getting you out of prison. But we did it because we believe that you're the one that can make the difference.
Yeah, superpowers.
Oh, and Havelock's looking for you.
I just talked with Havelock. Oh, right, he did say that we were going to talk more later. That's right. Sup, everybody? Let's party!
Martin's devised our next move. There's a footnote in Campbell's journal that tells us the Lord Regent's mistress sat for a portrait with Sokolov, the painter,
we should party.
The royal physician. He'll be able to give us her name.
I said we wanted to party. You're talking missions
Sokolov
at a party.
I can't believe what you've done so far. Escaping from Coldridge, taking down the High Overseer, recovering Emma.
Yep, that is what we've done so far. Thank you for that recap. We don't need a previously on Dishonored. I do enough of that myself. I'm just gonna head back up to my room. Make sure nothing appeared up there. Oh, sleep darts. I'm glad I checked. What? That's not finding ammo in greater amounts. I only got 2. All right, well, I guess it's time to head back out. How long have we been doing this? Oh, God, 2 hours? Yikes. This is gonna be a long one. I guess we better end the episode. Wow, I'm gonna be editing for a while tonight. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this fourth episode of Dishonored. Feel free to chat with me about it in the comments. Maybe leave an idea for another video I could do in the future. And I will see you all next time for the invasion of Sokolov's apartment. Catch you later.